Okay, so finishing up our AP review over limits and continuity. Continuity. Anytime we see the word continuity, we have to prove the three criteria. So the first criteria is that f of a must exist. That means there has to be a solid point. Second portion is the limit as x approaches a must exist. That means that the left-hand limit has to equal the right-hand limit. And the third criteria is f of a must equal the limit as x approaches a. So a function is not continuous if there are any sort of jumps or holes in the graph. So in this section, we'll be able to find vertical asymptotes, horizontal asymptotes, and any sort of holes in the graph. So first example, whenever we're doing this, the first step is to factor the bottom if it factors. Okay, so the bottom factors by difference of squares, x plus 2 and x minus 2. If we're looking at our domain of a rational function, which is a fraction, it's always going to be negative infinity to positive infinity. X cannot equal to negative 2, and x cannot equal to 2. So we set the bottom equal to 0. We'll have a hole in the graph, removal discontinuity, where it cancels. So at x is equal to a negative 2. And then whatever's left over on the bottom is our vertical asymptote. So we'll have a vertical asymptote at x is equal to 2. Now, if we're looking at horizontal asymptote rules, that's our top-heavy, bottom-heavy rules. So this is going to be bottom-heavy, so it's going to go to y is equal to 0. Now, if this question was to ask you for zeros, just say we're looking for zeros. You would take whatever's left on top, which is a 1, and set it equal to 0. 1 will never equal to 0. So there's no zeros, okay? So that's how we do removal discontinuities and all that good stuff. Next example, anytime you see a question like this that has solving for k's or a's or b's and it's a piecewise function, you have to make sure you set the branches equal to each other because the left-hand limit has to equal the right-hand limit. Okay, so from there, we're going to take our 0, and we're going to plug it in for x. So 0 minus 2 is equal to 0 plus k. So k comes out to be equal to a negative 2. This question shows up a lot on multiple choice. I don't know if we're going to see that type of question this year, but that's how we do it. If we're going to see something that deals with continuity or limits on the AP exam this year with free response, it's going to look something like this. Okay. So it says a 5,000-gallon tank is filled to capacity with water. At t is equal to 0, water leaks out of the tank at a rate modeled by the piecewise function below. Is it continuous at t is equal to 4? So we're going to go through our three steps. R of 4. So we're looking for the equal to branch with 4. So it's the top branch. So 300 times 4 is 1,200. And 4 plus 1 is 5. And this is going to be gallons per hour. Now, the second portion of continuity, part B, is we prove that the limit has to exist. So the limit as x approaches 4 from the left-hand side. Okay, we just found that. It's the less than branch, so it's going to be 1,200 over 5. And if we put that in the calculator, it comes out to be 240. Okay, if I do the limit as x approaches 4 from the positive side, we're going to plug into the bottom branch. So 500e to the negative 2, okay, because 0.5 times 4 is 2. Okay, so I'm going to put that in the calculator, and it's 67.667. Now, obviously, these two are not equal to each other. So that means that the limit as t approaches 4 of r of t does not exist. Therefore, not continuous at t is equal to 4. Now, we would have to go through the third step if this was true. So as soon as something's violated, we just stop and say it's not continuous at t is equal to 4. Okay? So that's a quick review of how to do the three steps of continuity. Now, next thing we're going to talk about is intermediate value theorem. So, intermediate value theorem pretty much says that in order for the intermediate value theorem to be satisfied, it has to either pass through a point or change sign. So if it's talking about zeros, which we're going to talk about in just a second, it has to change signs from negative to positive. In order for something to pass through, say this was 4, this would have to be like a 3, and this would have to be like a 5. So since it passes through 4, it guarantees satisfaction of the IVT. So on the first example, it says, does the following guarantee a 0 from 0 to 6? Okay, so we're going to do f of 0 and f of 6. Okay, f of 0, if we plug into our calculator, should come out to be 15, or you can just do it by hand. And if I plug in a 6, 6 squared is 36 minus 48 plus 15 should come out to be 3. Now, since there is no sign change from negative to positive, it does not guarantee a 0. So you say IVT does not guarantee a 0. Okay. Next one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug that in my calculator. Okay, so it says P of X is equal to 2X cubed minus 5X squared minus 10X plus 5. And I'm going to plug in my values, negative 1 and 2. Okay, so I get 8 and negative 19. Okay, so make sure your table's set on independent variable is ask. Okay, so we're going to say P of negative 1 was 8 and P of 2 is 19. Negative 19. Now, since there's some sort of sign change, IVT guarantees a 0 because of sign change. Okay. Now, if you see something that deals with IVT on the AP exam this year, it's probably going to look like this. Okay. So it says the table shows selected values of a continuous function from 0 to 13. What is the fewest number of times possible where f of x is equal to 4? So it passes through 4 from 3 to 4.5. Now, in order to go down to 3, it has to pass through 4 again. Okay. And so we go to 3. Now, if I go to 2.5, it doesn't pass through 4. But from 2.5 to 4.4, it passes again. So the fewest number of times where f of x is equal to 4, the correct answer should be 3. Okay? Now, we're going to look at some graphs now. And this is just a little bit different, so make sure you pay attention. So it says, given the graph of f of x shown below, and we want to determine if it's continuous at negative 2, 0, and 3. So x is equal to a negative 2. So x is equal to negative 2 is right here, okay? There's a jump in the graph, so I'm going to say not continuous. There's a jump discontinuity. Okay. At x is equal to 0. Okay. Now we're going to go through the three steps here. F of 0 is equal to 1. The limit as x approaches 0. Okay. If I go from the left-hand side, it should be equal to 1. If I come from the right-hand side, it should be equal to 1. Okay. So since f of 0 is equal to the limit as x approaches 0 of f of x, therefore, continuous at x is equal to 0. That's how we would go through the three steps for that. At x is equal to 3. So x is equal to 3 is right over here. So we're going to go through f of 3. F of 3, we're looking for the solid point. So it's negative 1. The limit as x approaches 3 of f of x. If we go from the left-hand side, it's zero. If we come from the right-hand side, it's zero. Okay? We'd say since f of 3 does not equal the limit as x approaches 3 of f of x, therefore, not continuous at x is equal to 3. And so we proved our continuity for both of the for all three of those points. Now let's look at this graph down here. So it starting with number 1, f of negative 5. F of negative 5 looks like it is 6. Okay, it's up here. F of 2 looks like it is 1. Oh, sorry. I keep hitting the camera. F of 4 looks like it is negative 3. That point right here, that's a solid point. Okay, now limits. The limit as x approaches negative 7. Okay, so if I come from this side, it's going to meet up at 2. The limit as x approaches negative 5, as I come from the left-hand side, it's 6. As I come from the right-hand side, it's 6. The limit as x approaches 2. Okay, so if I come from the left-hand side, it's 3. If I come from the right-hand side, it's 3. The limit as x approaches 4. Okay, if I come from the left-hand side, it looks like it's 2. If I come from the right-hand side, it's negative 3. So this one is going to be does not exist. The limit as x approaches 0. As I come from the left-hand side, it's going to negative infinity. As I come from the right-hand side, it's going to positive infinity. So this is does not exist also. And the limit as x approaches 0 from the left-hand side. Okay, that's what that means right there. Okay, so from the left-hand side, it's going to approach negative infinity. Okay, now it's okay to write negative infinity for one-sided limits. Okay, and then continuing with our graph. Okay, number 10, it says the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive side. So from the positive side, it's going up, so it should go to positive infinity. Number 11, the limit as x approaches 4 from the positive side, it looks like from the positive side, it's going to negative 3. Number 12, as I come from the left-hand side, it's going to be 2. Okay, the limit as it approaches negative infinity. So it's going to be what it lines out to all the way to the left. And it looks like it's approaching 0. As I go all the way to the right, limit as x approaches positive infinity, it's going to line out to 0. Okay, and then the last questions. Number 15, it says use the definition of continuity to prove f of is not continuous at the following point. So f of x is a f is not continuous at x is equal to a negative 7. So at negative 7 right here, there's a hole in the graph. So we'd say f of negative 7 does not exist. Okay. F is not continuous at x is equal to 2. We would say, so x is equal to negative 2. So f of 2 existed, the limit existed, but they're not equal to each other. So we would say that f of 2 does not equal the limit as x approaches 2 of f of x. Okay? And then at 4. So x is equal to 4 is right here. There's a jump discontinuity. So you would say that the limit as x approaches 4 of f of x does not exist. Now, leading into our next lesson on derivatives and differentiability, remember that a graph is not differentiable at sharp peaks, okay? So it has to be continuous in order for it to be differentiable. So like this point right here, this is not differentiable because it's going from a positive slope to a negative slope, so it's a sharp peak. It's also not differentiable where there's holes or asymptotes, okay? So hopefully this helps you better understand continuity, and hopefully you'll have a good night. Thanks, bye.